Have 1 minute. Okay, we're being recorded. As we get together here, it's wonderful to see all the Zoomers here today. It's great to see the congregation out there too. It's time to get started. So good morning.
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 Good morning.
Thank you, Zoomers. Let's try the congregation. Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning.
We'll wave at them. Maybe they'll wave back. It's good to see you all. We had a week of some health conditions in my household. We're all better, but not good enough to be there today. So we are using this blessed means of Zoom to lead worship this morning. I don't know what we'd do without it. And I'm so grateful for Zoom. I'm grateful for Zoomers and for you in the facility. What a blessed church we are.
Welcome.
Are we all, sounds like everything's going on pretty well. Our musicians today is Gary and Jerry and Dennis. I don't see Dale, so he's probably not with us this morning. Our worship leader, existing minister is Sandra. The reader is Richard. I will be presiding. The way I know at least two of the communion team, Vern will be serving the bread and Sandra will pour the wine, and we're going to harass someone else into carrying the tray. So we're looking at this morning at the third servant song as our sermon Bible study is kind of winding down. We have one more of these. In June, we discussed who the servant is. Then a couple of Sundays ago, we talked about the servant's mission. Today, we discuss obedience amid suffering. Mostly, it's about suffering and God's presence with us. In August, later this month, coming month, we'll speak more specifically about the suffering servant. Zoomers are going to help with the Bible study today. They're going to suggest words that touch their hearts today. And then I have a sermon to round everything out, because what would you do without a sermon? Anyway, are there any other announcements we need to make? I think Dorothy is around. I know she's feeling better. Does anyone have an announcement? That is Trink there today? Well, it's her birthday this week. We'll sing for her next week then. I hope she comes. Unless there's another. Oh, there she is. Hello. Look at you, Miss Wonderful. You just recover so fast. Good for you. So good to see you.
I think for anybody that might be put on Paxlovid, you're fine in 2 days. I mean, you feel fine. And then, so anyhow, not that I'm recommending it because it's still a controversy, but it does work. The reason I'm actually up here is because we are really trying to get a phone list together. So Kay Ames has printed out the phone list. Now, the one thing that is not on this phone list is your email, because we obviously don't have everybody's emails and we don't know who has one or who doesn't want to have it on here. So what I'm going to do is pass around this list, and you can check your information to make sure that it's correct. And then if you have an email and you want it added, hopefully we can get to most people about this so that we don't have to make individual phone calls to get the information. I don't know with the Zoomers, I see some of our people that sometimes are here need to be looking at it and whether they add their emails.
Those
people that do not attend in person at our church, I'm trying to think what the best way is for you to give us the information whether you want our email on our phone list. Maybe what I would do, I will give you, if you have a paper and pencil, I'll give you a minute to find it. This is our email address. So if you could email the church so that Kay Ames can pick up your email address, that might be the way we can do it the most efficiently. Anyhow, this is all lowercase. for our email address. It's Lutheran Calvary, all one word, at suddenlink.com. No, that's what's written here.
Is it .net? I don't know.
Okay, this is a good thing we're doing this because it is incorrect on this list then. So I will redo that for you. Okay, we'll start again. That was Lutheran Calvary, one word, no capitals, at suddenlink.mail. No. Somebody else should be doing this. Okay, that knows what they're doing. Okay, so I have it written on here now. Suddenlink mail. Now, is that all one word?
Yeah.
Okay, Suddenlink mail is one word, .com.
Okay.
So I'll do it one more time. Lutheran Calvary, one word, no capitals, at suddenlinkmail, one word, .com.
Hmm.
So hopefully it won't take more than a couple of more weeks to get this phone list together so we can be handing it out. And we will mail it to the people that are Zoomers that don't come into our church. Any questions? Okay. I will pass
it. Thank you. Thank you. I'm glad we, thank you. She's doing a good job. I kind of lost the ball there on getting that done. Anyway, we'll, if there's none other announcement, and I don't see Trink, so I think we'll begin our worship with the prelude by Gary. Oh, just beautiful. Thank you, Gary. What a great way to start. Please stand now for the peace. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Our gathering hymn is, Lord, speak to us that we may speak.
Lord, speak to us that we may speak in the living echoes of your tongue. As you have sought, so let us seek your strength. And alone. Oh, lead us, Lord, that we may lead the wandering and the wavering feet. Oh, feed us, Lord, that we may feed your hungering ones with manna sweet. Oh, teach us, Lord, that we may teach the precious truths which you impart, and wing your words that they may reach the hidden depths of many a heart. Oh, fill us with your fullness, Lord, until our overflow in kindling hot and glowing word, your love to tell, your praise to show. Amen.
The confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God, full of compassion and mercy, abounding in steadfast love. Amen. Trusting God's promise of forgiveness, let us confess our sin against God and one another. Eternal God, our Creator, forgive us all our offenses. By your grace, draw us near to you, our refuge and our strength. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Christ died for us while we were still sinners. For his sake, God forgives you and all your sins. Amen. The prayer of the day. Let us pray. O God, through suffering and rejection, you bring forth our salvation, and by the glory of the cross, you transform our lives. Grant that for the sake of the gospel, we may turn from the lure of evil, take up our cross, and follow your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Please be seated, and it's time for special music by Jerry and Dennis.
Something. Our meditative medley today is a response to Jesus' calling, "Follow me." The tunes reflect changing walk. You can apply whatever emotion you want to each of the different tunes, but you'll notice the part of my life that I consider the most joyful and pick up the step and dance a little bit.
Worldly pleasures all for
take me, Jesus, take me now. I surrender all. I surrender all. All to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. Take my life and let it be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Take my hands and let them move at the impulse of thy love, at the impulse of thy love. Take my feet and let them be sweet and beautiful for thee. Take my voice and let me sing always only for my King. Take my lips and let them be filled with messages from thee. Take my silver and my gold, not a mite would I withhold. Take my life and let me lean, filled with mess. I'm sorry. I did it again. I did this yesterday, so. Please start that again. Take my will and make it thine. It shall be no longer mine. Take my heart and it is thine. It shall be thy royal throne. Take my love, my Lord, I at thy feet, its treasure store. Take myself, and I will be ever only all for thee. Take my life, and I may be consecrated, Lord, to thee. Take my moments and my days, let them flow in ceaseless praise. Amen.
Thank you. I have never sung that tune, the last stanzas of that. It was wonderful, that tune you used. We'll continue now with readings. Richard is our reader today.
First reading is from Psalm 116, verses 1 through 9. Please read responsively. I love the Lord who has heard my voice and listened to my supplication.
For the Lord has given ear to me whenever I called.
The cords of death entangled me. The anguish of the grave came upon me. I came to grief and sorrow.
Then I called upon the name of the Lord. O Lord, I pray you, save my life.
Gracious is the Lord and righteous. Our God is full of compassion.
Over the innocent. I was brought low when God saved me.
Turn again to your rest, O my soul, for the Lord has dealt well with you.
For you have rescued my life from death, my eyes from tears, my feet from stumbling. I will walk in the presence of the Lord in the land of the living.
The second reading is from the 8th chapter of Mark's Gospel, beginning at verse 27, a reading from Mark. Jesus went on with his disciples to the villages of Caesarea Philippi, and on the way he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that I am?" And they answered him, "John the Baptist, and others Elijah, and still others one of the prophets." Jesus asked them, "But who do you say that I am?" Peter answered him, "You are the Messiah." And Jesus sternly ordered them not to tell anyone about him. Then he began to teach them that the Son of Man must undergo great suffering and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and after 3 days rise again. Jesus said all this quite openly, and Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. But turning and looking at his disciples, he rebuked Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan, for you are setting your mind not on divine things, but on human things." He called the crowd with his disciples and said to them, "If any wish to come after me, let them deny themselves and take up their cross and follow me. For those who want to save their life will lose it, and those who lose their life for my sake, for the sake of the gospel, will save it. For what will it profit them to gain the whole world and forfeit their life? Indeed, what can they give in return for their life? Those who are ashamed of me and of my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, of them the Son of Man will also be ashamed when he comes in the glory of his Father with the holy angels." Here ends the reading.
Thank you, Richard. Now it's time for the reading of the third servant song. You will notice that there are two versions. There's this one that I'm going to be reading is from the NRSV. That's the version that is the Lutherans like. And there's an alternate version. It's a New English translation. Sometimes if you compare and contrast, you understand the reading more clearly. That's why there's two of them. But as I read this text, I urge you to listen for a word, a phrase, a verse that moves you in this reading. Those in the congregation, I will not ask for your word today, but I do hope you choose one and make that part of your devotions this week, and think and ponder on it, pray on what that word or verse or whatever that you hear. I will begin. Isaiah 50, 4 to 11, the third servant song, a reading from Isaiah. "The Lord has given me," the servant says, "a trained tongue, that I may know how to sustain the weary with a word. Morning by morning he wakens my ear to listen as those who are taught. The Lord God has opened my ear, and I was not rebellious. I did not turn backward. I gave my back to those who struck me, and my cheeks to those who pulled out the beard. I did not hide my face from insult and spitting. The Lord God helps me, therefore I have not been disgraced. Therefore I have set my face like flint, and I know that I shall not be put to shame. He who vindicates me is near. Who will contend with me? Let us stand in court together. Who are my adversaries? Let them confront me. It is the Lord God who helps me, who will declare me guilty. All of them will wear out like a garment. The moth will eat them up. Who among you fears the Lord and obeys the voice of his servant? Who walks in darkness and has no light, yet trusts in the name of the Lord and relies upon his God? But all of you are kindlers of fire, lighters of fire brands. Walk in the flame of your love and among the brands that you have kindled. This is what you shall have from my hand. You shall lie down in torment. Here ends the reading. This reading is ancient. It covers ancient thoughts. So some of that is more difficult to understand. However, it is filled with deep theology, and we're going to talk about that a little bit. But first, I'd like to ask the Zoomers what word or thought or phrase comes to warm your heart today. Anne, what do you say?
When I first read this, I read it all the way through, and then I went back and read it again. So I really actually liked the first phrase, the Lord God has given me a trained tongue. What does that mean? I thought, what does that mean, a trained tongue? When I looked on the other side, it says the sovereign Lord has given me the capacity to be his spokesman. So that's what it meant to me, that you have the ability to speak well. You can speak poorly, you can speak in anger, or you can speak in love. But God teaches us, Christ teaches us to speak in love, to speak well of others, to ask forgiveness, to forgive others. That's what I'm thinking when I see a trained tongue.
Beautiful. Thank you. Bev, what about you? We can't hear you, honey.
About that. There you go. Okay. Verse 10. I went there because this whole reading is about the servant's suffering.
That's exactly right.
And to me, everybody sitting there today and here, we have all also walked in darkness and with no light. We have experienced that. Yet, like the servant, we choose to place our trust in our Lord and maintain our faith.
Thank you, Beverly. That is the key verse in this whole reading, or at least the theological verse. That's the one we're going to be talking about. Penny, what one did you choose?
I, like Anne, went for the very first. The Lord has given me a trained tongue that I know how to sustain. I went to, Jesus was highly trained. And so if I'm to represent Jesus, I too need to be highly trained. And that opportunity is there for all of us to have that training. He is the master servant. And a trained tongue uses its ears to speak, is what I got out of that first.
Very good. Yes, exactly. Thank you very, very much. Renee.
Well, I think we had a consensus here, but I like the first verse and the verse 10, those two together. So
good for you.
What I got out of it was that God has given his servant the words of life. And if we choose to listen to his servant and obey him, we don't need to, as it says in verse 11, kindle fires or light flaming arrows to send into the dark, because we can walk in the light of our servant.
Beautiful. Beautifully done. Thank you. My word, I think, is on verse 7. It says, I have set my face like flint. That's what servants do. They set their face like flint, meaning if you look on the other alternate translation, that is, I will be steadfastly resolved. It takes some strength in the servant, the strength that God gives us to do these words that you're talking about, this trained tongue. But again, the key verse of this text is 10. Who among you fears the Lord and obeys the voice of his servant? Who walks in darkness and has no light, yet trusts in the name of the Lord and relies upon his God? That is the theme, the servant's song, this particular servant song. Again, this reading is ancient. and it's extraordinary. It is theology. We use it within our faith now. In it, we can clearly hear that you and I will never suffer alone, for God doesn't remain an observer, but intentionally enters into our sufferings, taking our pain into himself to suffer along with us and for us. This reading is called the Third Servant Song. It was written 2,500 years ago as the Babylonian exile of God's people was coming to an end. During this exile, the people had suffered. They were in a crisis of identity and of faith. They were defeated, their temple destroyed. They'd been taken in chains out of their homeland into Babylon. They felt alienated from their land and abandoned by God. They even wondered if they were still able to worship, if they were still God's people. They needed help. God's servant came to them. He set his face like flint, or was steadily resolved as he entered the trauma of God's people. The servant doesn't lament, doesn't cry about the suffering, but gives words of hope and confidence of God's presence. The servant doesn't try to justify or understanding the suffering the people were going through, but he tried to help the people to endure with hope. As the servant reminded them of who they are, the people returned to God and became faithful in their suffering. Endure with hope is a legacy of faith that our exiled ancestors gave us. They continue to give us to endure with hope. Through this legacy of faith, we can find the source and endurance of God's people, the Jews. They have learned to endure with hope, and Christians too. Through this legacy, we see that whatever pain we suffer, whether is from in our nation and our community, our family of faith, or even individually, we can hope in God and endure with hope. But as you know, there's no guarantee that we won't suffer. All of us have. There's no guarantee that faithful people won't be treated cruelly. They have been. Yet in this broken world where nothing lasts, we're given an unshakable, eternal promise that God won't leave or forsake us, that nothing in all creation can separate us from God's love, and that when we pass through deep waters or walk through hot fires, God goes with us. We can trust this promise. In scripture, we learn God is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love. That God is completely faithful and never gives up on us and works to make everything and everyone right. In short, God loves us and suffers with and for us. So who is God's servant? An ancient prophet? Yes. The people of Israel? Yes. Jesus? Definitely yes. You and me? Yes, definitely. Certainly through Jesus, the greatest of servants, we can watch God himself suffer on the cross. It's out of love that God uses the only way that will work to break the power of evil in this world, and that is to absorb it. In the 1900s, she's from Spain, Sister Josefa Mendez, in her beautiful confession of faith, declares that in the mysterious event of the cross, an abyss of sin, violence, and suffering has been swallowed up by the suffering of divine love. That's what Jesus did. On the cross, out of love, Jesus set his face like flint, and for once and for all, took into himself the pain and suffering of this world. He absorbed it, so we might find peace, freedom, and new life. And that's what God's servants do. They set their faces like flint and willingly follow God's loving purpose, no matter where it leads. You and I must discern what our path is. Our path is not to the cross. Jesus did that already for us, but it does go somewhere, and there will be suffering. Because here's the thing. You and I are called to be God's servants, to set our faces like flint, to be steadfastly resolved, to make God's love known, to help break the power of evil that remains, to bring healing and peace and freedom to those who are suffering in this broken world that God loves so much. And the world is suffering. We are needed. We are God's servants. It's not so easy to do. So we're going to pray. So please pray silently and add your own petitions. O Lord God of steadfast love and faithfulness, our world continues to suffer, and yet you call us to set our faces, to be your servants, to help those in pain. Please add your own petition for help. We need your love and strength. Help us, O Lord. We know we've contributed to the world's suffering through our broken lives and sinfulness. Please add your own petitions and confessions. We need your love and healing. Forgive us, O Lord. O Lord, we're grateful for your presence and your mercy, your gifts of new life and fresh starts, for being made to be your people and to be called as your servants, for your gifts of love and faith. Please add your own petition of gratitude. We give you thanks and praise, O Lord. Thanks be to God. Amen. Please stand and let us sing the next hymn, Will You Come and Follow Me? It's also called The Summons. It's an extraordinary hymn for people like you and me. So please stand and let us sing.
Will you come and follow me if I but call your name? Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown in you and you in me? Will you leave yourself behind if I but call your name? Will you care for cruel or kind and never be the same? Will you risk the hostile stare should your life attract or scare? Will you let me answer prayer in you and you in me? Will you let the blinded see if I but call your name? Will you set the prisoners free and never be the same? Will you kiss the leper clean and do such as this unseen and submit to what I mean in you and you in me? Will you love the you hide if I but call your name? Will you quell the fear inside and never be the same? Will you use the faith you found to reshape the world around through the sight and touch and sound in you and you in me? Lord, your summons echoes true when you but call my name. Let me turn and follow you and never be the same. In your company I'll go where you love and footsteps show. Thus I'll move and live and grow in you and you in me.
congregations around the world, we confess our faith in the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We pray for the church, those in need, and all of God's beloved creation. Gracious God, raise us up as your servants to bear witness against sin, death, and the grave. Lord, in your mercy.
Prayer.
Sovereign God, embolden people around the world to seek the common good, to serve their neighbors, and to delight in freedom. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Loving God, still your children wander homeless, hungry, and naked. Strengthen us to be your presence as we care for all those in need. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Welcoming God, thank you for this congregation where we have found a home. Help us find creative ways to expand our loving invitation to all people who seek a community. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Please remember those on our prayers concern list and include me for my surgery on Wednesday. Members and friends of Calvary, members and friends serving in the military, and our partners in the ministry. In every time and every place, you have raised up examples of loving service. Make us all good and loving witnesses to your extravagant compassion. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer. Gracious God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your boundless mercy through Jesus Christ. Amen. Please be seated, and it's time for Gary's special music.
Thank you.
Thank you. Always beautiful.
Let us pray. Blessed are you, O God, as you have raised us to new life in Christ. Give us generous hearts to respond to those in need. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
It's time for Holy Communion. So those who will not be receiving communion at the altar rail, gather the elements so that we can continue. So together, let us make the sign of the cross as these words are said in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Holy God, our maker, redeemer, and healer, when sin had scarred the world, you sent your Son to heal our ills and to form us again into one. Please lift the bread. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Please eat of the bread, body of Christ given for you. Please lift the cup. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is a new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Please drink of the cup, blood of Christ shed for you. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Communion blessing for those who have communed. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. And now for those of you who are about to commune, the Lord Jesus Christ dwells with us here. We who are hungry and thirsty, come to the table. The table is set. All are welcome.
Your only Son, no sin to hide. But you have sent him from your side to walk upon this guilty sod and to become the Lamb of God. O Lamb of God, sweet Lamb of God, I love the holy Lamb of God. O wash me in precious blood by Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. Your gift of love we crucified. We laughed and scorned him as he died. A humble king we named a fawn and sacrificed the Lamb of God. Precious blood by Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. I was so lost, I should have died. but you have brought me to your side to be led by your staff and rod, and to be called a Lamb of God. O Lamb of God, sweet Lamb of God, I love the holy Lamb of God. Oh, wash me in your precious blood, my Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God.
Let us pray. O God, we thank you that you have fed us again with the food of everlasting life. Send us out, call others to your feast through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Our ascending hymn is, Lord, dismiss us with your blessing. Please stand as we sing.
Dismiss us with your blessing, fill our hearts with joy and peace. Let us eat your love possessing, triumph in redeeming grace. Oh, refresh us, oh, refresh us, traveling through this world. Thanks we give an adoration.
Final blessing. May the Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you now and forever. Amen. Please be seated for the postlude by Gary. Just beautiful. Thank you. Thank you. Okay. Thank you.
Okay, Zubers, unmute. Go at peace. Make God's love known. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Oh, that was delightful. Thank you all. Congregation in the facility, thank you so much for being so faithful and being there today. Thank you, Zoomers, for your help with the sermon. You were wonderful. Peggy, what a delight to see you. It's just such a, yes, let's wave to Peggy.
Hi, Peggy.
And Sandra, where you're going to be in our prayers, just so you know. You do such a good job. God bless you all. Have a wonderful week. Stay healthy. Bye now.
Bye.
Bye.